Items that are needed for the fog machine jack-o'-lantern include a jack-o'-lantern, a fog machine, for this example a 400 watt fog machine will be used, a fog machine timer or remote control is recommended, tubing, for this video 1¼ flexible drainage tubing from a sump pump drainage kit will be used. Also we'll need aluminum foil, tape, and it's recommended that you use T light emitting diodes instead of a candle. You can also use glow sticks instead of using T light emitting diodes. Also, each fog machine is a little bit different, so you can change the setup as you see fit. On the table are the fog machine, two pieces of aluminum foil sheets that are 2 feet long, tape, and tubing. You can always cut the length of the tubing to meet your needs. Also, please be careful around the fog machine output nozzle. The output nozzle gets very hot and can burn you. Also, it can melt the plastic tubing. In addition, try not to cover the breathing ribs of the fog machine. Since this video is using plastic tubing, the tubing should be just a few inches from the port when the foil is applied. If the tube is not in the right spot, the fog will not come out the tube. This takes some practice to get it right and can be a little frustrating at times. The fog machine is placed near the side of the foil. The foil is wrapped around the fog machine and taped into place. Then the hose is correctly positioned in the foil, and the foil is crimped around the hose and held by the tape. As a side note, I found that the fog coming out of the tubing works well when making ground fog. Since it's not a good idea to use candles with the fog machine, I will use T light emitting diodes. Two T light emitting diodes are placed in the jack-o'-lantern. The T light emitting diodes give a realistic candle glow. In the back of the jack-o'-lantern, I have carved a hole that will fit the tubing. After placing the tubing in the hole, it is time to test the fog machine.